called to choose destiny. Jeremiah 1:4-5. Then the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee, and before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations. Psalm 139:16. Thine eyes did see my substance, yet being unperfect, and in thy book all my members were written, which in continuance were fashioned, when as yet there was none of them. As with Jeremiah and David, whose call came before entering into their mother's womb, so it is with every man and every woman born. However, through the provision of free will, God has left it to each one's choosing as to whether or not that call will be lived out. Jesus said it himself, Matthew 22:14, For many are called, but few are chosen. The choosing comes by the decisions we make along the way as to whether or not we are able to be a resting place for the fullness of his glory. He will not put on us that which we are not prepared to carry, lest it destroy us. Destiny calls each one of us, and it is the exercising of our free will that determines the outcome of that calling. As our hearts continually respond to the voice of our Creator, I choose you, above all else, I choose you, we navigate our way through our destiny. He is our origin, and he is our destiny. We were in him before the worlds began, and we return to reside in him, and are even now residing as we partake of his grace by way of accepting and receiving the benefit of the shedding of his blood. It is the journey from here to there as we run the race that plays out the days written in his book ordained for each one of us. It happens one day at a time, one decision at a time, to choose him above all else. In this living out of our lives, turning toward him at every juncture, and once again, consciously making a decision to choose him, we find ourselves in the middle of our destiny, for it will only be found in him. Acts 17:26-28, And hath made of one blood all nations of men for to dwell on all the face of the earth, and hath determined the times before appointed and the bounds of their habitation, that they should seek the Lord, if haply they might feel after him and find him, though he be not far from every one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being, as certain also of your own poets have said, for we are also his offspring. In our Western mindset, we have made our destiny to be an end to a means, a job or a title that we attain to. It is a form that we desire to create for ourselves, a position to be held, such as singer, a pastor, or perhaps a banker. I'm not sure that is what God had in mind at all. For many of us, it might just be the reason that our destiny seems to elude us as the years wear away on our hopes of stepping into what we perceive as our destiny. We try to create a form within which we will function, form first, and then function comes as a result of our Greek reasoning that has so enamored our culture. Our true destiny is hidden in the function of living out the days he fashioned for us, not a title or a job description. It's not about being a prophet, but rather the process of learning how to hear his voice and prophesy in love with the heart of the Father. In that functioning as a prophet, we truly find our destiny, which is to become like him. It's the same for every job and or ministry title you can come up with. Though we all have different days written out for us in his book, still the process of learning how to function is the walking out of our destiny, to be like him, to be one with him. Our destiny is not the end product, but rather the journey to that end, our days lived out as God himself has written them in his book. Our life lived in him day by day is our true destiny as we become more like him. The form in which that takes place, whether it be, as I said, a teacher, evangelist, or baker, is secondary to the function of walking out that process. I'm afraid we lose the joy of that journey because we are waiting to attain a position or name or whatever. It's the days that we have lived up to this point with all the mistakes and all the failures and even successes that make up our destiny. I believe we get misled by regarding destiny as a noun, when in God, it really is as much a verb as it is a noun. It is probably even more accurate to say it is a person, the process of becoming one with the personhood of Jesus Christ. Regardless of the job, the process is the same. It is in the functioning of our calling and the process that brings us to maturity concerning it that is our real destiny. It is the same for all of us. So we are exhorted to not despise the day of small beginnings and to count all joy as we maneuver through life, through the good, through the bad and the ugly, through the gory and the glory of it all. Whether you are aware of it or not, you are in your destiny right now. All of our days are the summation of who we become in him. The ones lived out behind the scenes are just as, if not more, important than the ones in front of people in that perceived place of successfully functioning in our calling. I find that very encouraging, knowing that this is all working toward the fulfillment of our destiny. It's about the choices we make in the days of disappointment, heartache, and being betrayed that brings us to the place of love and unity with God. We can choose to feel sorry for ourselves or to complain about where we are and how long we are there or the seemingly bad break that actually, probably, kept us from going through a door that would have led us in the wrong direction. Our other option is to look into His eyes and say, I choose you. Whatever that looks like and however long that takes, above self and all else, I choose you. It is also about how we handle promotion, favor, and prosperity. The point is not that we receive these things. It is about how we rule and reign in that position. Do we take advantage of it for ourselves, or do we use it to pour out on others? Do we use our favor to strengthen and lift others in their calling, even above ourselves? In the midst of all the advantage it affords us, is there still an automatic cry that comes from within, Lord, I choose you. You are my portion. You are my destiny. Song of Solomon says it well. Song of Solomon 8, 6, and 7. Set me as a seal upon thine heart, as a seal upon thine arm. For love is strong as death, jealousy is cruel as the grave, the coals thereof are coals of fire, which hath a most vehement flame. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can the floods drown it. If a man would give all the substance of his house for love, it would be utterly contented. The questions asked when we pass from this life are more like, do we look like him? Did we learn to love? Did we die daily to ourselves so that it is no longer I that live, but Christ living in me? Our true destiny is in him, to become like him, regardless of our calling. That puts us all on the same level before him, no matter what our job description or calling is. As the bride of Christ, we are to take on the very nature of our bridegroom and move through life as he did. To look like him, to act like him, to respond like him, to be one in him is our destiny, regardless of the form. He is our destiny. Ephesians 1, 10 and 11. That in the dispensation of the fullness of time he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth, even in him, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestined according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will. As we approach this fullness of the times, there is a gathering together of those who function with this understanding. We are to be those who love as he loves, to the extent that we become walking love and would be willing to lie down our very lives, preferring others before ourselves. That is our destiny in this hour. Regardless of what form our life takes, the purpose is to function in that kind of selfless love as we become one with him in his likeness. That level of maturity, death to self, will draw his presence. We are called to be the bride of Christ, fully functioning in our destiny as we live, move, and have our being in him. It is only out of this place that he can trust us with the never-before-seen authority and creative word that is about to be released through those who cry, We choose you. Above all others and all else, we choose you. We have walked out our destiny as we have made him and him alone our boundaries and borders, a city whose walls are made of his fire, his jealousy, his authority, his very presence upon us as we become his resting place. Zechariah 2:5, For I, saith the Lord, will be unto her a wall of fire round about, and will be the glory in the midst of her.